brand's wrapper. Something like this can add credibility to the product or service we're talking about. Of course, it helps if these companies use the product or service and that there's an explicit endorsement in which these companies say it's okay that the product or service can feature these brands. It also helps if the product or service isn't entirely fictional. To create our section, let's drag in another section, and we can place this section right underneath our first section, our hero section. Just like we did in our hero section, we'll drag a container in so that all of our contents can be neatly bound towards the center. And we can save some clicks, Command-K or Control-K, to type in grid and drag the element straight from QuickFind into that container. All right, let's configure our grid. We'll want a total, in this case, of 3 rows, and we'll also want a bunch of columns. How many? 4. So we'll click to add 2 more. With our grid still selected, let's name the class to keep everything organized. We'll name this one Brands. And for the section itself, let's name that too. With the section selected, we'll give it a class of Brands Section. And with that, we can affect the padding. We'll click Option to adjust both sides at once. And now we have spacing at the top and bottom. Let's drag in some of our content. First, we have a heading, and that heading is currently white. We can't see it. The heading color is white and the brand's color is white. So let's change the typography color for the section to a gray color. That'll affect the children, including this heading. Let's get that color just right. And once we do, we can save it. We can create a new swatch, and that means we can reuse it elsewhere. Let's click out and continue. With our heading selected, we can have that heading span not one column, but all 4 columns. And we'll want to center that content. We can just center the text. By default, headings are set to H1. Let's make this an H2 in terms of the hierarchy. And we can double-click to edit the text, pasting in what we had on our clipboard. What about the other 8 cells, the other 8 cells underneath? Well, we can simply add our logos to those cells. We'll start with Chipotle, of course, Sephora, IBM, Zapier, Stuff, Tech Insider, Google, and with a significantly less dramatic entrance, Forbes. Now let's try and make everything in our brand's grid more uniform. So with any of our images selected, we can create a class. We can call this Brand's image, and we can make the height more uniform, something like 50 pixels, maybe a little bit more than that, around 55 pixels, and we can apply that same class to each of these. So we can simply select brand image, and what'll happen here is as we apply the class to IBM in this case, and Zapier, is it's going to set a fixed height of 55 pixels. Each of these, since they're using the same class, will apply that height, but the best part about this is we can make changes to any one of them, and they apply to the rest. We'll demo that in just a moment, but first, let's make an adjustment to our grid. Now, we can adjust the layout on this multiple ways. We can do it on the grid, or we can do it on the grid child. So, with the grid child selected, let's set center. That works for Zapier, but has no effect on the rest. So, instead, let's select our grid parent. Set the children to horizontal center, and all of them just center. It just works. Let's add a little spacing. To do that, we can just adjust the row gap. We're just changing the gap between each of the rows. Once we're done, we can click out. That looks a lot better. Now, let's adjust the color. We're not going to do that on the brand's div itself. We're going to do it on the brand's images. So we can add a filter. Now, filters let us adjust things like blur, but they also let us adjust contrast. And the reason that's helpful, once we select contrast here, the reason that's helpful is we can make them all the same color. Dropping contrast desaturates them, but unlike grayscaling them or dropping the saturation, they are uniform. Okay, so that's everything we need for now on desktop. In the next video, we'll make sure everything scales when we view this on all sorts of devices.